lot of variety to, you know, the guys and their styles, you know, the hat shapes, the way he wears his clothes or whatever. You know. Typically, if you see a guy in a flat hat, you know, flat top, flat brim, my first assumption is he probably takes after Buckaroo style to a degree, if not like sold out all the way. You'll either see him wearing like some heeled riding boots or just a regular set of lettuce pickers. A lot of guys wear Levi jeans in this style, I've noticed. There's guys still wear Wranglers, but a lot more Levi's. Another little telltale sign is a lot of guys have a little, for their pocket knife, they have a little pouch that it goes in, then a lace that ties to their belt loop. And during brandings, that's often just left hanging out. They can grab their pocket knife pretty easy. Most, about any guy out in Nevada that I've seen has one of those in his pocket. And that's not, none of this is absolute, you know. Well, out here, it's predominantly like a Buckaroo style. You don't find very many. You find some guys come up from Mexico or Arizona, but and other places, but yeah, it's mostly just Buckaroos on like all the big outfits. Basically, everybody got like slick, like on mule hide or leather, and most guys pack longer ropes, it's like 60-foot ropes. It's a pretty consistent style, I think, that you find out in Nevada. Like back in Colorado, you know, it's kind of a big mix pot. You got the Texas Waddies and the Brush Poppers, Okies. They all come up with their bell bottom chaps, taco hats, you know. A lot of those guys tie on with short ropes. And you get guys from Wyoming, you get guys from California, Montana, more Buckaroo style. And then there's just like the, I don't know, it becomes kind of traditional. It's kind of, or a plain cowboy, you know. So yeah, it's, in today's age, whereas we got vehicles and guys can travel around a lot easier, you know, but everything's mixed together more, whereas, you know, back in the day, the way it was done in that area was kind of style, you know. But, yeah, so it's mostly just the Buckaroo type out here. Some guys see a horse as a tool to go out and get a job done, which, you know, that's when I think more guys in the Buckaroo style tend to put a little more time into their horses, make them put a really good handle on them. I think the better your horse handles, the better you'll be able to do your job. I like my horses to be pretty soft in the face. That's another difference there. There's not something. There's guys in every style that have great horses and they're great hands. You know, it's just a different style, different way of doing things. I don't think it's wise to knock anything different, so long as you can see that the results are getting the job done well and efficiently, you know, without costing horses or cattle or people their well-being. Everybody kind of takes on their own style and puts together their gear and their outfit, what works best for them, what's comfortable for them. But a lot of guys ride like a slick fork saddle with a weight horn. Swell fork, but that was more, I wanted to build a swell fork, so that's kind of what I'm riding on right now. I like it, but I like the slick fork as well. You only ride these style, these are called Rommels, you only ride these reins with this style of bit. But yeah, this is like the finished setup. It's like this style of head stall is the only kind you'd really ride with. I mean, there's variations of this, but it's the only kind you'd ride with this kind of a bit. This is called a bridle bit. When we get home, I can show you the other stages of the bridle horse. We have the, so like see these knots here, kind of help him feel. So like when I move the rein this way, he feels those knots on his neck. When, ideally, these are a little bit long. Ideally, it should be to where your hand is down when you're just riding. So just the smooth parts on his neck, then when you pick up, it pulls the knots. You know. So it kind of helps him feel that a little bit. The chains just add a little bit of weight, kind of help that give it a little life on the bit. So when I pick up, he feels it. So he starts to collect his head a little bit. The Buckaroos tend to... I know there's a couple sides to that answer. Part of it's in how we handle cattle, how we do things. Like I said, we rope longer ropes. Buckaroos tend to, you know, we got, not always out on the ranch, it's more of a practical type of roping, but there's still a variation of loops that we can throw. Some of them are a little more fancier than others. Sometimes they're just different. People automatically think it's fancy, but it's just the shot that got the job done. And then, you know, the gear is a big telltale sign of what you are. There's some guys who like to mix a little bit of everything, and that's their style, and it's whatever, but I think if you take after a style, you should do your best to learn everything about it and perfect those skills, I guess.